There is one thing that will distract you away from your mission. Like, distractions as a whole is built on the foundation of this one thing. You must understand that the seriousness of this. There is one thing that literally undermines everything you do as a man, or fuels it. It's your emotions. As a man, if you allow your emotions to dictate your actions, to dictate your mission, your future, you're not gonna live a good life. And we, as modern young men who have been brainwashed by the education system, who have been brainwashed to be more feminine, your female teacher, when you were 5 years old, told you to like act exactly how a feminine, like how a female, like a girl would. We are so in touch with our emotions, and that is not a good thing. Because there is a difference between being in touch and, you know, being emotional, to being aware of our emotions. Being aware of your emotions is a fucking top tier skill. Being aware of your emotions means you feel the emotion and you can almost label it. Like, I'm feeling angry right now. Why? I'm feeling really, really jealous of that person right now. Why am I feeling that? That is being aware of your emotions. That comes from things like meditation. That is so valuable. But being emotional, this is what the modern world want you to be. The modern world will literally try and convince you to be emotional. Be in touch with your emotions. Being emotional means that you feel that anger and you are angry because you're emotional. You feel that jealousy and you are jealous, and so you do something in spite of that person that you're jealous of. You don't want to live a life like this because your emotions change very frequently. You know this. What time is it that you're watching this video right now? Since you woke up, you have changed the emotions 50 times. How is it that you wake up maybe in a good mood or a bad mood, and it can literally change within 10 seconds of a random thought, of a random conversation, of a smile of a stranger? Your emotions just all over the place, all over the place. And that's normal. That is normal. It's normal to just your emotions being all over the place. That is literally just what emotions are like. But being emotional then means that you are all over the place. It means that you are angry, then sad, then excited, then happy, then horny. You'll go all over the place. You will be like this weird man who's just fucking everywhere. Your emotions will constantly keep going and going and going and going. But being aware of that and then being in control of your emotions, but at least being detached away from them. Oh yeah, I feel angry. With almost interest. You're almost looking at your emotions with interest. And you're almost like with a smirk on your face. Like, oh yeah, like, I feel, that's the symptom of being angry. Like, I literally just felt my forehead get a little bit hotter. That's interesting as fuck. Compared to the guy who feels angry, and so he is angry, and so he punches someone, and now he's a dumbass. Your emotions will distract you away from your mission more than you realize. Like, if there's anything that distracts you, it's simply because your emotions got you there. Think about these modern addictions. Why do we go on them? Porn, video games, social media. Why do we go on them? Is it not because of our emotions? You see, like, the nerds at the Silicon Valley, they know this shit. They know that you will start to get emotions that you associate with going on the platform. When you feel lonely, deprived of intimacy, horny, you go and watch porn and you jack off. When you feel maybe insecure, when you feel inferior, you go on social media. Now, of course, these things make you the thing as well. So going on social media makes you feel insecure. But there is a certain emotion. There's a reason why your brain just chooses to click on that app. There's a reason why your brain just thinks like, yep, now is a good time to play video games. You didn't consciously sit there with like literal words in your brain thinking, I think I'm going to go onto social media right now because I want to look at people who are hotter than me. You didn't sit there and, oh, consciously, like, I think I will play League of Legends right now for 2 games. You don't consciously think this shit, do you? You get a feeling. You get a craving, you get some kind of feeling, some emotion that then dictates your actions because you are an emotional man. You related to what I was just saying and now you're offended because I called you an emotional man, but that's exactly what an emotional man is. If you weren't an emotional man, you wouldn't have related to everything that I just said in the last few minutes. And to make you feel better, bro, I'm emotional too. It's something that I'm working on, and you should too. The first step to improving yourself is really just having the humility to totally see your weaknesses. And so I'll hold my hand up. Yep, I have a tendency to be quite emotional. My emotions are quite like strong and fickle and all over the place. And oftentimes I'm not good enough. I'm not developed enough to kind of stay vigilant and aware of that. I'm working on it. I really hope you are too. Because the progress that you make here in controlling and really observing your emotions and detaching away from them will then mean that when your emotions change, but it was time to work on the mission, you will continue working on the mission. Today you said you were going to do this piece of work, but you wake up and you don't feel like it. You're tired. So many thoughts, excuses in your mind. If you're an emotional man, you will listen to those feelings, those emotions, and you will then not do the work that you said you would, and you will literally become less masculine, less successful, less proud of yourself because of that. Get this into your mind. As a man, you know, there's a lot of talks about like self-love and everything. Those things are absolutely fundamental for you to have a good life. But as a man, the way that you achieve self-love is different than how like feminine, like weak men and then women do. If you are more on the masculine side, you achieve a level of like self-love, self-respect, when you do the things that you said you were going to do and you build yourself up. Almost no young men have a good level of self-love because they are literally just too low in the social hierarchy to feel happy with themselves. As men, we feel happy with ourselves when we are up on the climb of the ladder of like the social hierarchy. We feel happy when we are taking steps up the mountain to our mission. To think, this is like a modern paradigm which I totally disagree with, to think that you can like love yourself unconditionally even if you're a fucking slob, I think it's a lie. I think you can love yourself when you treat yourself with respect. You can love yourself when you've been doing the right things. You can always have an underlying like appreciation and, you know, love for yourself, but you will totally feel like in love with yourself. You will totally feel happy when you have made good progress to your mission, when you are currently making good progress to your mission. As soon as it stops, as soon as you have like one full day of being a Jeffrey, 2 days of being a Jeffrey, fair enough. After that, bro, of course you start to feel bad. You know, you lose 50 pounds, so happy. And, you know, you said at the end of this diet, you're going to have that cheat meal. You have the cheat meal, you know, it's kind of hype. And yeah, let's go get some Krispy Kreme donuts and shit. Oh, yeah, nice. It's nice. But, you know, sometimes you kind of, you know, you have this cheat meal and you end up, like, just having two more after that. You know, you get into momentum and everything. And then you feel like shit 2 days later. Like, oh, yeah, I said, you know, I've lost 50 pounds, but I just went up 4 pounds in the last 2 days. Like, just lost that sense of, like, achievements for yourself, that sense of happiness, of positivity, as it should be. Keep your focus on the mission. If there's like a piece of advice I could give to men who want to become more masculine, it's just simple as that. Keep your focus on the mission and just realize your own thoughts, your own emotions will just be all over the place. And if you just go at the whims of your emotions, you won't be making good progress on your mission. And when you don't make good progress, you don't feel good about yourself. You don't feel happy. Progress to your mission creates happiness and fulfillment and a sense of like freedom for a masculine man. Click on this video to learn more right now. Do the hard work, especially when you don't feel like it. Mwah.